We are joined by Secretary Mike Pompeo, Senior Counsel for Global Affairs, and obviously someone who has been making the rounds on the news, talking about just the mess that is going on currently in Afghanistan. Secretary Pompeo, I don't know if you saw President Biden's speech yesterday, seems to be pointing a lot of blame in a lot of different places, and seems to be also be giving a conflicting message. What is the difference in what the strategy you were trying to implement and accomplish in Afghanistan? Obviously, we've all kind of been a little more informed on all of those inner workings just in the last few days, and what this administration did, the Biden administration, as we've seen just a tragic mess.
Well, look, this is not the time for assignment of blame. We've got to make sure we get the Americans there that are trapped, some of them trapped inside of Afghanistan deep, some of them in Kabul and around the airport. We need to make sure that our military is focused on that and that alone. We got to make sure we get those folks out. But as for the strategy, we were very clear. President Trump wanted to get our boys and girls home. No, nobody is squawking the objective of getting our men and women out of Afghanistan. But they seem to have forgotten two basic rules. One, you have to execute this in a way that reflects the history and the context of what's going on. And second, there's a real responsibility to make sure that we reduce the risk that we're ever attacked from that place again. And President Trump gave me the mission to do each of those two things. We withdrew 12,500 folks, so call it 80%+ of our forces. We had drawn down to around 2,500 by the time we left in January of last year. And we had stability. We hadn't had an American killed since February of 2020 because the Taliban understood that President Trump and I were serious about protecting America. From the pictures you can see on TV, it does not look like our leader has done this. It looks like this weakness that you see around the world with respect to the Russians, that were at the table in Vienna with the Iranians. That weakness was something that came to be known by the Taliban, and they ran the table. And now we find ourselves in a place where the president says he'd planned for everything, but yet had to, on an emergency basis, send back in even more troops than were there 12 months before that. It's really sad.
Mr. Secretary, you mentioned the mission was to make sure the capacity for an attack against the United States from Afghanistan was diminished. And as you mentioned as well, that there had not been a loss of life for an American soldier since February of 2020. But with such a chaotic exit, has the threat from Afghanistan risen dramatically just over these last few days?
So my guess is, you know, the direct threat for tomorrow probably hasn't changed a great deal. But remember, this is always about context. We end up focusing on the number of boots on the ground. That's too narrow a lens. But make no mistake about it, if you're Al-Qaeda, if you're ISIS, you can see now that there's a space that this President Trump and I made very clear. If we see this buildup, if we see Al-Qaeda, if we see terrorists from other organizations, we're going to go back in and do what we need to do to take that risk down. My guess is that they are emboldened. They can see that if they find ungoverned space, this administration is likely not prepared to inflict the costs on them to keep America safe and secure. So whether the risk is any greater as we sit here today, I don't know. But over time, American weakness, America's absence of leadership around the world, it begets war. It creates risk for the American people. I pray that that will not be the case, but I fear that the full context, whether it's what's taking place with the Chinese or the Russians, but they all watch this. Xi Jinping is watching. Chairman Kim is watching. They can all see how America responded and its inability under President Biden to execute a mission that it was working on. I think it absolutely increases risk to the United States.
You know, Mr. Secretary, this is Wesley. You know, I think about just a lot of the foreign policy decisions that have been made, policies that have been put in place, some of the rhetoric. You know, it seems like this administration lacks some clear direction and strategy and consistency with foreign policy. And I'm curious, was this all this happening over the last few days in Afghanistan the natural outcome of an administration without a clear foreign policy?
You know, in some ways, that's a really good concept, right? This is a symptom of their failed understanding of how you secure American freedom and how you protect America. Right? Look, it's a combination. Right now we have terrorists that have run over a country who will try again to kill America. We have a porous southern border, so people can freely travel, including radicalized terrorists who can come across. We're going to provide them aid in traveling around our country. We've defunded, demoralized our law enforcement community, the tools necessary to protect and serve. we now are telling people that, yes, they need to go cover up again, right? All with the virus, all of these things are interconnected. It is the combination of these things that increases risk so greatly. They don't understand the central precept of American security, which is to establish a deterrence model that makes it known to the world that your leaders, your American leadership, is going to be present, and we're going to protect the things we care about, our vital interests, and we're going to do so in a way that we never apologize for securing American freedom.
Thank you, Secretary Pompeo. Well, another question. You know, a lot of people, America is a compassionate place. We're a compassionate people. When you see these kind of imagery from anywhere in the world and double down on it being somewhere where we have such a presence, and you see people clinging to airplanes to escape, I guess our concern, a lot of people's concern, is the safety of not only the people that fought alongside us, partners, and the people of Afghanistan, as well as the United States citizens, but is also, like I said, the people who have looked to the U.S. for comfort and for safety. How should this be addressed? Do you have a thought on this? I know that this is a big question that a lot of people are we all can look at it and go, this is horrible. It's going to be horrible for women. It's going to be horrible for everyone in Afghanistan. But what can be done at this point? What would you? How should this be addressed?
So we always came back to the central thesis of what are the things that are vital American interests. And so there are tragic things that happen in lots of places in the world, and we do our best to help ameliorate all of these risks to people around the world. We worked on religious freedom. We worked on human rights. Those were important things for the United States. But in the end, with respect to sort of the basic living conditions, right, the building of a nation there in Afghanistan, that is going to fall directly to the Afghan people. It's the negotiations that we had begun, right, with the Taliban. They were a little bit about things military and then a lot about things security, but also about trying to get Afghans, Pashtuns, Tajiks, people from the north, people from Herat in the west, all the elements of Afghan society to find a set of accommodations that could deliver the very human rights understandings that you are describing. It is difficult to watch. It is very sad. But the use of America's military power, they're putting at risk of our sons and daughters in a place like Afghanistan, has to be confined to those places where there is an absolutely vital American interest. We can't be everywhere and all things to everyone.
Secretary Pompeo, we appreciate you coming on and giving your point of view. Obviously a very knowledgeable and a very specific outlook and outplace. That's why, you know, the ACLJ, I want to say this, we have some incredible people who are part of our team. And Secretary Pompeo is one of those people. You've heard him on this show multiple times a week for many months now, as he can weigh in unlike anyone really could weigh in on this topic. And that's why we have people like him on our team. And that's only because of the work and the support of people like you at the ACLJ. If you want expert analysis, expert opinion, as well as true, real litigation and legal response for you and for all that you stand for, that's why we have the ACLJ, and I haven't spent a lot of time this show talking about it, but I never want to, you know, leave a show without saying that the work of the ACLJ is vitally important, and we only can do it because of you. And as for right now, the month of August, all donations that are made to ACLJ at ACLJ.org are effectively doubled, which means there's another ACLJ member on the other end that is saying, I will pledge to donate and match that person's donation, and there's a whole group of them. So it can be at any donation for the month of August. It is incredibly effective and incredibly important. So I encourage you to go there to not only donate, but also to see all the great content. There are blogs going up from people like Secretary Pompeo, from Rick Grinnell, from Wes Smith, from our team here. Every day there's brand new content at ACLJ.org. It's not as much a news source as it is a source to really break down and understand what's happening in the world and some of the things that you may not know are happening in the world. So again, thank you to Secretary Pompeo for joining us.